Bonjour, we are back after Diwali's break. So, we are continuing with our lesson. Before we begin with our lesson, which is new one, I would like to talk about some basic grammar roots. Now, four terminals you all had from lesson 1, 2, 4, 5 and 6 from textbook, workbook and your exercises from it with numbers. We'll start with numbers. You already learned from 0 to 20 last year and from 21 to 100 this year. The basic rule of numbers are that they are les nombres cardinaux, the cardinal numbers, the French name of it, and the 3 till 100, that is 100. It has some basic rules. From 0 to 60, it goes straightforwardly, like the 3, then 11, 12, 13, then 21, 22, 23, then 31, 32, 33, 41, 42, 43, 51, 52, 53, then 61, 62, 63, 61, 62, 63. The little bit of maths takes place when it starts from 70. Till then, from 0 to 69, it goes straightforwardly. The numbers which you have learnt. It is only from 1 to 20 which you have to arrange and then you'll get your ultimate number, that is 7070. 70, how will you get? 60 plus 10. 60 is 60 and 10 is these. If you add both this 70s, it becomes 70. Same way 71. If you add 60 plus 11, it becomes 71. 71, 72, 73, 4, 73, 4, 5, till 79, 79. 80, 80, how do we get? 80. 4 is 4. And if we multiply 20, it becomes 80. So 80 in French is QUATRE dash in between VINGTS. 80. Only 80 has vin in plural by ending in S. Now from 81, it becomes 80. So here if we write QUATREVINGTUNN, in this 81 till you go for 99, 80 will not take S. Only in 80 it will take S, and the rule is given in the textbook itself on page 56 and 57. It is given here. And in 21, 31, 51, 61 and 71, ETA, that is end, in English is written in between. While in 81 and 82, 81 and 91, it is not put. So, it is 80. In the beginning, I told 80, which was wrong, but it is 80, because 81 and 91 will not take ETA in between. And from 91, if we add 80 plus 11, 80, 90, then it becomes your 91, 92, 93 till 99. So 80 is 80 plus 19. Now, what is 19 in French? 19. So, if we write full, 99, it becomes 99, and 100 is 100. So, you have little bit of maths from 71 till 99, and 100 is totally independent. So, then you have from 21 to 71, ETA in between, 81, 91 will not take ET and in between. And only 80 has the S in last in the spelling of when. Other 80 doesn't have S at the end. These are the simple rules for the numbers. You already have learnt alphabets and its spellings. This year also you learnt alphabets and its spellings. Then you have your different other grammar rules which you had in your chapters. Like chapter number 2, which taught you Komu Sawa once again. Then it also taught you those magical words which you learnt last year. And difference of tu and wu. Tu is informal, wu is formal. From chapter 3, you had your verb, which is known as etre. You had question, ki es and qu'est-ce que c'est. Then you also had from lesson 4, your basic adjectives. Masculine, feminine, singular, and masculine, feminine, plural. Okay? Adjectives to describe someone, something, or the whole group which you can describe. Okay? And also some new rules for plural. For example, a kahiye, de kahiye. De kahiye, kahiye will have s at the end. Yun fleur, de fleur. De fleur, F-L-E-U-R-S, S at the end. And we all know in French, some letters are silent at the end. This was the main basic rule. And the first and foremost basic rule was, and is also now too, that we have to write French and English spoken differently, and it has totally a new meaning to it. Okay, then we had again some plural rules. Few letters ending in S, X and Z will not take an extra S. For example, any, deni. Any, a nose. Then if we write D-E-S, they, any S. No, sorry, N is Z. Z, the spelling is ending in Z, so it will not take extra S. Same way, if it is ending in EU, AU, and EAU, for example, Engato, Evazo, the ending is EAU, it will not take S at the end for plural, but it will take X as the plural in the end. For example, un gâteau will become des gâteaux. Ending in EAU, the spelling changes as G A with circumflex T E A U X. Because it is ending in EAU, it will take X as the plural but not S. So remember this rule. Same way, for opposites in adjectives. In adjectives, the opposite will have masculine singular, will take masculine singular in opposite. For example, petit, grand. Petit means small, grand means big. And as they are masculine singular, it will not have S at the end, neither E at the end. And same way, feminine singular will take feminine singular as opposite in the end. So if I say the same word, petit grand, by adding e, it becomes feminine. Petit and grande. The pronunciation also changes. And opposite, small and big. Now, masculine singular will take masculine singular as opposite. Same way, masculine plural will take masculine plural in opposite. Do not mix up all the things. Feminine plural will take feminine plural only. If I take the same example ending in s, the spelling and pronunciation will remain same, petit grand. And in same for masculine feminine plural, petite grande. They all will have s at the end, but do not mix up with each other. Remember this properly. Then we had to change in plural the sentences to change. For example, cet un garçon. C'est apostrophe est, c'est un and garçon. This is a boy. What would it be in plural? These are some boys. Because in singular it is, this is a boy. Un union de is given. So plural will take for un and un, des, they only. Ce sont des garçons. These are some boys. Okay? Same is there in il est mauvais. He is bad. Then what is the plural of he? They. So what will we write in plural? Ils. Il. Il est. He is will become they are. Ils sont mauvais. As mauvais is ending in s, it will not take extra s. Okay? Same way, elle est grosse. She is fat. Then, what are the changes in plural sentences? They are fat. Elles sont grosses. E-L-L-E-S, L, space, S-O-N-T, sont, space, G-R-O-S-S-E-S. We have to make it plural. Is will become are, so a will become sont, a and un will become they, lola will become les. Okay? Now, change the sentences in feminine. Now, feminine, we have to make a change from masculine to feminine. Il est beau. He is handsome. Then what would be in feminine? Ill will change to elle. L. Esta will remain same. Beau, beau, that is handsome, will be change to beautiful, that is belle. B-E-L-L-E. Then how the sentence will go? Elle est belle. She is beautiful. From masculine to feminine is changing the sentence of feminine. But usually we make mistake by making it plural and plural sentence to feminine. Both are mixed up. So, never mix up your sentences. In lesson 5, you had comprehension with its exercise describing the room, describing each and every thing which is there in the room, and your verb avoir, to have. Then you had the most important topic of numbers. Then you had your exercise related to it. That's why the basic rules of grammar goes. Most importantly, it was needed to do a small recap. In the blanks like put articles definite and indefinite. For example, Je dash Bobon the Mari means Je et Bobon. Now we have to remember the object, whether it is masculine or feminine. Then, if this object is belonging to someone, it will take the definite article. First it will be indefinite, then it will be definite. Okay. For example, nous avons dash robe. Ce sont dash robe de Marie. Nous avons des robes. We have some dresses. These are some dresses or the dresses. Some will change to the. So, because it belongs to someone, it has someone else's possession. These are the dresses of Marie. So, it will be they and le. You do not have to write any number or any other word for this simple sentences. Just read it and then attempt the question. Same way for fill in the blanks by putting avoir and être. If you remember your verbs avoir and être with its singular and plural side and its English meaning, it becomes easy. When you read the sentence, try to convert them into English. You'll immediately know what to put in the blank. Okay, this is the simple rule. So, we had this introduction of some basic rules once again, just to get a small revision out of it. See you in the next lecture. Till then, au revoir.